Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming out of number 45, and I specifically wanted to do it with the Graph and Calc iPhone app. And so here we need to find the zeros of this function. So I'm going to hit my Y equals button, which is this top left button. And I know you can't see me pressing my fingers, so I'm just going to say all this stuff out loud. And you see I already entered in my calculator, the function that's in question. Now I'm going to go just to the right of that Y equals button where it says graph. And here's where the physical calculator and the app really differ. And it's how you graph that makes it different. So I'm going to hit graph here. Oh my gosh, you can see I have a stat plot on. Let me go ahead and get rid of that. So I'm going to turn this bad boy off. So just hold tight. Okay, now I'm going to hit graph again. All right. Now we can see in here that my window's a little messed up. And the reason was because I think the last time I was using this app, I must have been doing a stats problem for my Math 43 class. And this is just a great example of how I need to reset my window. So if you have the physical calculator, you hear me say a lot of times, use Zoom 6, right? Zoom standard. And it's different on the app. So if you look in the bottom left-hand corner, you see that word Zoom. So I'm going to push my finger on that word Zoom, and this menu pops up. And it's not Zoom 6 on the app. It's actually all the way down. You got to read to Zoom standard, or it says Z standard. So I'm going to hit Z standard here. And then you're going to see this window resets. It goes from negative 10 to 10 on the x-axis as I move left to right, and negative 10 to 10 on the y-axis as I move down to up. And I can see my two zeros in here. And the cool thing about the app is you can put your finger on the green parabola here and trace it. So I'm just going to put my finger. You're going to see this circle with a crosshair pop up. And then all I need to do is trace it. And you see it kind of latches on to really important points like the y-intercept. Now, we weren't asked for the y-intercept here. We were asked for the zero. So there you see the first zero at 0.131. And I'm just going to continue to trace it. It'll also give me the max, but let me scrooch back down. And there's the second zero at 2.535. So I actually think the calculator app is better at finding zeros than the physical calculator. You also have the option if you want, if you look down here at the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see the word done. And I can, to the left of that is the word calc. If I hit that, I can actually move here to zero. And then you can do the same setup that you would on the physical calculator. If I look at my first x-intercept, I think it's somewhere between an x value of zero, so I can enter that in, and one, enter that in, and then it captures the zero. You can see it saying there, hey, it's at 0.131. And if I look on the graph, this next x-intercept, it looks between, it's somewhere between x equaling 2 and 3. So I can head back up here and I can say 2, oops, yeah, I know there's no real answer. There we go. And 3, and then it'll latch on to the second zero. But I would argue just tracing it out with my finger is a little bit faster. So that's how you can do number 45. All right, thanks so much. Bye.